Hello friends, the teacher here. In this Excel 2016 tutorial video, we will learn that how to protect a worksheet. When you first click the Protect Sheet option from the Format drop-down menu of Home tab, you are presented with several predefined options. I will explain you all these options in brief, but let's first protect this worksheet with the default option settings and hit the OK button. When you go with protecting a worksheet with the default options, the entire worksheet gets protected, and you are not allowed to modify the contents of the worksheet. You can also notice on the ribbon that most of the commands are disabled now. It is an easy method of protecting an entire worksheet with the default options without configuring any special settings. But there is a drawback going with the default protection settings. Anyone who knows how to protect and unprotect a worksheet can easily unprotect the worksheet by just clicking on Unprotect Sheet options from the Format menu. As your worksheet was not protected with a password, so anyone can easily unprotect the worksheet and can modify the contents. The first thing that you should take in consideration is always protect a worksheet using a secure password, so any unauthorized person may not be able to modify the contents of your worksheet. You need to enter the password twice to confirm it. Next time, if you or anyone else will try to unprotect the worksheet, he may require to enter the password to modify the contents. Now let's talk about the other default options that you see under Allow All User of this worksheet 2. Here you can see that two options are checked by default, which are Select Locked Cells and Select Unlocked Cells, and all remaining options are unchecked. So what does enabling this option mean is, even after protecting a worksheet either with or without a password, the user will still be allowed to run those enabled options even inside a protected worksheet. For instance, as these first two options are enabled and after applying the changes, I am still able to select all the cells of this protected worksheet. I will explain you what locked and unlocked cells are in a minute. Let's again go to Protect Sheet and uncheck both of these options. And now you can see that I am not even allowed to select any of the worksheet cells. Let's enable a few more options while protecting a worksheet and see what happened then. For example, I enabled Insert Columns and Insert Rows option and then protect the worksheet. As the worksheet is now protected, I am still allowed to insert new columns and rows inside this worksheet. So this way, you can allow a user to perform certain operations even inside a protected worksheet. Let me tell you the most important part of protection, and that is locked and unlocked cells. In Microsoft Excel, when you open a new workbook or start working inside a new worksheet, by default, the entire worksheet contains locked cells. To confirm this, let's first select a few cells anywhere from this worksheet and then right-click and choose Format Cell command. Click the Protection tab and you can see that Locked option is checked and this option is enabled by default on the entire worksheet. Doesn't matter which part of the worksheet you select to confirm this. So what does locked cells mean and how it works? As you have seen that the entire worksheet is locked by default, but that doesn't really matter on an unprotected worksheet. You can click and type anywhere in a new worksheet and can modify the contents of an existing worksheet. But when you protect a new or existing worksheet, all the locked cells get protected and you are not allowed to modify the contents of the locked cells. As by default, all the cells are locked, so you are not allowed to modify any content of a protected worksheet. Here is another example of for your reference. While protecting a worksheet, even if you allow to insert columns and rows, but you still not be able to write inside the newly inserted columns and rows because they are locked by default. So, how we can protect or unprotect certain parts of a worksheet? To do this, what you need to do is to unlock those columns and rows or cells where you would like the user to modify the contents before protecting a worksheet. As an example, we have this detain marks worksheet, where I would like the user to enter the data in the entire worksheet except for the columns where formulas has been used. I don't want him to modify those columns which contain formulas. So, first I unlock those columns in which I want user to enter data by first selecting them, and for non-continuous selection, you can hold down the Ctrl key. Now, right-click on any of the selected column and click Format Cells from the context menu. Click the Protection tab and then uncheck Lock option. That's it. Now protect the worksheet and the user will be able to modify the contents only in the unlocked columns, where the columns which contain formula will remain protected. This way you can protect or unprotect certain parts of a worksheet. You can repeat the same steps to lock or unlock certain parts of a worksheet. I hope you will find this video informative. Tell us by hitting the thumbs up button, by leaving your comments, or by sharing this video with your friends. Subscribe to the teacher for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and take care.